Congrats, you've got the job, you start tomorrow.
When since that sister's taught weird breeds, that's not the apostolic way.
Are you from here? I ask because your features, especially your hair, looks different.
Oppressed and singled out in every case where my roots are concerned. I used to hear about this, but now as a victim I've surely learned.
In the 1960s when the movement begun, they had every right because even now the battle has yet to be won.
You question my identity, you question my choices and my freedom. You tell me what you would prefer to see without valid reasons. Aren't I a daughter? Aren't you a son? Do we not have blood? So why as a woman do you wish to reduce my preference?
Growing up, they said long and silky was the way to go. But the revelation is Untamed and Kinky is here to steal the show.
And oh, I've just come to know, certain terminologies do not empower me. Won't let this Eurocentric system devour me?
And then my own people asking about my ancestry, because my curls get looser and my hair slicks back smoother, but that's another thing that adds to our division, Rooster. We need to recognize diversity with precision.
The exclusions, the prejudice, lens check, and texturism won't do much for the culture. Why do I live in a world where my blackness can be imprisoned?
You say you don't see it? Because it's covered in rose-colored glasses. Nobody's asking. We're checking YouTube for styles but not discrimination. The blatant segregation. The high expectations of black women to wear wigs and hair pieces. A commonality in the nation. I was born black, raised black, so I'll wear my hair like that. As a matter of fact,
I'll do so glorifying in this crown without a moment's hesitation. Oh glory, let the runners for black hair acceptance keep racing.